Good morning, children. Welcome to the online classes this year. Let's all have a 1 minute of silent prayer. Okay, are you all ready to come back to your classes? I mean the online classes. Have you all had a very good vacation with your family during lockdown? Hope you all have enjoyed the vacation. So shall we start doing our lessons? Let us have a fun-filled year this year. I'll be teaching you English, and I hope that you all have bought your English text, Be High. So today we are going to start the first chapter from the English Reader, The Fun They Had, written by Isaac Asimov. Isaac Asimov was an American writer of science fiction and popular science books. He was the professor at the Boston University. Isaac Asimov is the writer of The Fun They Had. He was a professor at the Boston University, and he wrote many science fiction books and books on popular science. In this lesson, written by Isaac Asimov, The Fun They Had, this prolific writer envisions what the schools and the education system will look like in the 23rd century. The story opens with Margie, a girl of age 11 years, writing a note in her diary dated 17th May 2157. It is about 137 years ahead. So the story is all about the futuristic school. Already you all are in the first step of the futuristic school, getting ready with your online classes, but there is a slight difference between the school that you are attending and the futuristic school mentioned in the story. In this story, the futuristic school, the subjects are taught by mechanical teachers or robotic teachers, whereas in your schools, you are taught by human teachers. The Fun They Had, written by Isaac Asimov. So we'll go on to the lesson, and before you read, I hope that all have taken your textbooks. Textbooks will be in front of you. Just look at the screen. So before you read, the story we shall read is set in the future, when books and schools as we now know them will perhaps not exist. So the writer introduces us to the futuristic school and says that the story is set in the future when there will not be any books or schools. You will be sitting at home. Your future generations will be sitting at home and learning lessons from mechanical teacher. There is no need for a particular building as that of a school. How will children study then? Let us find out from the diagram given here. Schools of the future. So you'll be sitting like this in front of the computer screen, and you will be learning through computers. There will be robotic teacher and moving e-text. You now have printed text to study, whereas they'll be having just moving e-text, and millions of books can be uploaded in that e-text. So in pairs, discuss three things that you like best about your school and three things about your school that you would like to change. Write them down. It's up to you. You can do all this right in your assignment book. In pairs, discuss three things that you like best about your school. These are all general things that you ought to know. In pairs, discuss three things that you like best about your school. You may be missing your school now. So write three things that you like best about your school and three things that you would like to change. Change is always for good. So write them down. Have you ever read words on a television or computer screen? Can you imagine a time when all the books will be on computers and there will be no books printed on paper? Would you like such books better? I mean the e-books. Would you like such books, the books better? So these are all for you to read and understand. And these are all for you to... These are all for you to read and understand and note down. Now let us start the text. Para 1. Margi even wrote about it that night in her diary on the page headed 17th May 2157. So it's 17th May 2157. She wrote, "Today Tommy found a real book." The real book mentioned here is the printed book that Tommy had found from the attic of his house. So, Tommy is Margie's neighbor, and Tommy is 13 years old, a bit elder to Margie. And Margi is 11 years old. So Margi found that Tommy has found a book from the attic of his house, and the book was a real book, very old and crinkly. The pages were yellowish in color because it was very old. It was a very old book. Margi's grandfather once said, when he was a little boy, his grandfather told him that there was a time when old stories were printed on paper. So Margi remembers her grandfather saying that when her grandfather's grandfather was a little boy, they used to read printed books. They used to have printed books. Whereas now, Margi and Tommy were following e-books. So e-book, they were familiar with the e-books, but they were quite unfamiliar with the printed books. They are seeing this book for the first time. So they were very curious. They turned the pages, which were yellow and crinkly. What is the meaning of crinkly, children? Crinkly means having many folds or lines because of overuse, because it was very old. And it was awfully funny. The writer says that the book that Tommy found from the attic was awfully funny. Awfully means extremely. Awfully means extremely funny. Extremely funny to read words that stood still instead of moving. In the e-text, they had this moving text. They can read any number of books. And the letters kept on moving. Whereas in this printed text, printed book, the words stood still instead of moving the way they were supposed to on a screen, you know. So Margi and Tommy was quite unfamiliar with the printed kind of book. And then when they turned back to the page before, it had the same words on it that it had when they read it the first time. So once they turned the pages, it was all the same. It didn't move. It was quite different from the e-text that they were following. So I'll read it out to you once again. And then when they turned back to the page before, it had the same words on it that it had had when they read it the first time. I hope you all have understood the first para. So as you read, you should go through the glossary words given on the side of the pages, because those words you need to learn. Those words will be asked in your extract questions. Now, moving on to the second para. "Gee," said Tommy, "what a waste." "Gee" means Tommy didn't like that. What is the use of such a book, he thinks. When you're through with the book, you just throw it away. You don't need to keep the book for a long time because it is of no use. Whereas your telly books, you can keep it for a long time. You can read any number of books from your telly books. Whereas this book is of no use, I guess. Our television screen must have had a million books on it, and it's good for plenty more. He says that our television screen, our telly books, must have had a million books on it, and it's good for plenty more. Our television screen must have had a million books on it, and it's good for plenty more. You can read any number of books from the television screen. I wouldn't throw it away. He says that I wouldn't throw my telly books away, but I will throw soon after I read this book. I don't like to keep this printed book anymore. So Maggie says, "Same with mine," said Maggie. She was 11 and hadn't seen as many telly books as Tommy had. He was 30. So now the author writes about Maggie. "Same with mine. I also have telly books, and I'll keep my telly books so that I can read any number of books from my computer screen." She was 11 and hadn't seen as many telly books as Tommy had. Tommy is a bit elder to her. He was 30 and Maggie was 11. She said, "Where did you find it?" She's asking, from where did you get the book? So Tommy was deeply immersed in reading that he didn't want to answer that question. In my house, he pointed without looking because he was busy reading. He didn't even look at Maggie. He was deeply immersed in reading the book that he just pointed out that I found it from the attic of my house. What is an attic? Attic, a space just below the roof used as a storeroom. So you can store old things and many things in the attic of your house. So from the attic of Tommy's house, Tommy got this book. And the book was a printed one. So Maggie again asked, "What is it about? What is the book about? So Tommy says that it is all about school. The school mentioned here is the school of the past, the ordinary school, the school that the older generations attended. So Maggie asks, "What is the book about?" And Tommy says that the book is about school. Maggie was scornful. Scornful meaning she didn't like the idea. She was contemptuous, showing you don't like something. Maggie was scornful. "School? What is there to write about school? I hate school." Maggie hated school like anything. She was scornful. "And what is there to write about school?" So Maggie always hated school. But now she hated it more than ever. Maggie didn't like attending the mechanical school, the futuristic school. Maggie always hated school, but now she hated it more than ever. There are many reasons for her to hate school. Let us find out. The mechanical teacher had been giving her test after test in geography, and she had been doing worse and worse. So basically, they had to learn three subjects: mathematics, geography, and history. And Margie hated learning geography because the mechanical teacher had been giving her test after test in geography. Soon after a test was over, she was asked to write another test, and she failed in most of the tests. She was not performing good in geography, and she was getting poor marks. She had been doing worse and worse until her mother had shaken her head sorrowfully. Mother was very upset seeing Margie's performance, and she shook her head sorrowfully and sent for the county inspector. Mother sent for the county inspector. Who is a county inspector? A county inspector is a person who comes to check the flaws in the computer. He just comes to see whether anything is wrong with the performance of children, whether anything is wrong with the sectors in the computer. So she sent word to the county inspector. Margie's mother sent word to the county inspector, and he came. Now, children, let us go on to the fourth para, describing the county inspector. He was a round little man with a red face and a whole box of tools with dials and wires. So that is the appearance of the county inspector. And he came to Margie's house, and he smiled at Margie and gave her an apple. The county inspector smiled at Margie and gave her an apple in order to impress her. Then took the teacher apart. The teacher here is the geography sector. Took the teacher apart means the geography sector. The geography sector is mentioned here. As Margie was performing badly in geography, her geography sector was taken apart by the county inspector in order to check the flaws. Margie had hoped he wouldn't know how to put it together again. She didn't want to attend classes for a few days, so she thought he wouldn't know how to put it together again. He didn't want him to bring it back very soon. But he knew how, all right, and after an hour or so, there it was again. So from this sentence, you can understand that Margie was not even spared for an hour. It was brought back and fixed in an hour's time. You know why Margie hoped for this? Because once Tommy's history sector has completely blanked out, and it was taken away for a month. So he didn't have to do his history lessons for a month. So Margie was hoping something to happen like that, but her geography sector was brought back within an hour. Margie had hoped he wouldn't know how to put it together again, but he knew how, all right, and after an hour or so, there it was again. It here means the geography sector. Large and black and ugly, with a big screen on which all the lessons were shown and the questions were asked. So soon after one comes in front of the screen, the children were asked questions by the mechanical teacher, given tests by the mechanical teacher, and soon as you come and sit in front of the computer, you will be asked to put your previous day's homework in the right slot. So all those things Margie hated the most. She didn't want to attend classes. That wasn't so bad. So the appearance of the screen was not so bad as So she is going to compare, the writer is going to compare this part with something else. What Margie hated the most was the slot where she had to put homework and test papers. She should be regular in putting her homework, previous day's homework, in the right slot. And she has using a punch code. Using punch code, she'll have to submit the homework in the right slot, and she'll have to do test papers. She and Tommy, any child, will have to put the previous day's homework in the right slot, and test papers were given by the mechanical teacher. And soon after a test was done, the marks were calculated within no time. She always had to write them out in a punch code. They made her learn when she was 6 years old. Soon after she had started studying in that school, she was asked to learn the punch code. And they made her learn, means the mechanical teacher made her learn the punch code when she was 6 years old. And the mechanical teacher calculated the marks in no time. So within few minutes time, she got her marks. I hope you all have understood till para 4. Just read the lessons. As you read, you'll understand better. Go through the glossary words given. Let us go on to the fifth para. The inspector had smiled after he was finished and patted Margie's head. So remember, the county inspector came to her house to find out what was wrong with Margie's geography sector. So as soon as he has finished fixing the sector, he smiled and he said to her mother, "It's not the little girl's fault, Mrs. Johns. Mrs. Johns is Margie's mother." Mrs. Johns is Margie's mother. So he tells Mrs. Johns that it is not the little girl's fault. I think the geography sector was geared a little too quick. She couldn't understand. She couldn't do well in geography because it was geared a little too quick for her age. So what he did was that he slowed it down to an average 10-year level, so that Margie can understand her geography lessons better and perform well. So he says that those things happen sometimes. Sometimes with the mechanical teacher, those things happen. And so I have slowed it down to an average 10-year level. Actually, the overall pattern of her progress is quite satisfactory. She's quite all right. Nothing is wrong with Margie or her performance. The thing was that the geography sector was geared a little too quick for her age. So I have slowed it down to an average 10-year level, so that the overall pattern of her progress is quite satisfactory. And he patted Margie's head again in order to cheer her up. He patted Margie's head again. Margie was disappointed. Why was she disappointed? She had been hoping they would take the teacher away altogether. Margie was quite disappointed. She had been hoping that, like the way Tommy's history sector had been taken away, they would take her geography sector away for a while. They had once taken Tommy's teacher away for nearly a month because the history sector had blanked out completely. So she wanted the same to happen here, but it never happened. So she said to Tommy, "Why would anyone write about school?" So in the previous paragraphs, the writer has shown why Margie hated school. So now she is asking. So remember, they were reading the book, the printed book, and all these went through her mind while they were reading the book. So she said to Tommy, "Why would anyone write about school? There is no need to write about school. Nothing is interesting about school," because they were attending the mechanical school. Children, hope you all have understood till para 5. I want you to read the lesson very well till para 5. Remember the name of the lesson, The Fun They Had, written by Isaac Asimov. Remember to go through the glossary words given on the side of the text. Read line by line till para 5. Now let us see a video on the lesson, The Fun They Had, written by Isaac Asimov.
Thank you.
No, soon after this, I'll be recap. That's all. No, no need to see this alone.
Thank you.
sister. So children,
ഇത്
കഴിഞ്ഞ് ജസ്റ്റ് റീക്യാപ്പ്
ആൻഡ്
ഐ എം കൺക്ലൂഡിംഗ്. Let it be like this. Children, now a recap of the lesson that we have done till para 5. The few points that you have to remember are the setting of the story, that is the 23rd century, that is the first point. Margie's diary note, headed 17th May 2157. The third point, the real book that Tommy finds from the attic of his house. The book was all about the schools centuries ago. Now the writer describes about the schools centuries ago. Then the school in the story, about the school that Margie and Tommy attended, the mechanical school. Margie's poor performance in geography. The county inspector coming, finding the fault and slowing the level to an average 10-year level. Margie's disappointment because her geography sector was brought back soon, not like Tommy's history sector. And then Margie's thoughts. That comes towards the end of the lesson. We'll be doing the rest of the lesson tomorrow. Hope all of you have understood. Children, I hope you all have understood the lesson. Just read the lesson very well, line by line. Understand the glossary words. I hope you all have enjoyed the video. So the next session will be starting after 10 minutes. You can take a break.